Oh yeah, family, it's morning time. Welcome to the celebration, morning motivation. I am Deacon Ford, and we're here once again to give God all glory, all honor, all praise. For this right here is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. It's morning time, family. Let's get into this word and see what the word's saying. Okay, morning to you. Good morning to you. Good morning to y'all. I see y'all logging on. Brother Charlie, I see you on here. Brother Terrence, Deacon Doc, my cousin Nikki, good morning to you. Sister Ellie, good morning to you. Sister Hall, good morning to you. Sister David, good morning to you. I see you on here. Sister Pam, Sister D, good morning to you. It is morning time. Oh, yeah. Y'all see it for the word. Listen, man, good morning to each and every single one of y'all. We are blessed. We are blessed once again with the breath of life in our lungs. God has assigned us. Hear what I just said. Now, he assigned us to this day. He assigned that we would wake up and we would be allowed to see another day, man. He blessed us once again. And so we're gathered together to give his name all praise, all honor, and all glory. For those of you, this may be your first time tuning in. We are the Morning Motivational Family. I am Deacon Ford, and we are here to celebrate the breath of life. And before we get into that, y'all know how we do, man. Y'all come in real quick. Big hug to each and every single one of y'all, man. Big hug to y'all. Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning to you. I thank y'all for being a part of the Morning Motivational Family. Shout out to those who are going to log on at a later time. Those who go who just view it, man. Who just are in the views, you don't make yourself known. Shout out to you. The other platforms that log on, Instagram, YouTube, Big John Russ, my niece Daisy, Sister Cheyenne, we are so happy that you made it home. We still praying for you, sis. Mother and Deacon Robinson, Evangelist Pons, Deaconess Petronella, good morning to each and every single one of y'all. Thank y'all once again. Thank y'all for being a part of the Morning Motivational Family. As y'all can see, I'm feeling a lot better from yesterday. I could breathe a little bit better. I still got the little sinus thing going on, but that honey, that lemon, and that ginger tea, oh man, it'll do it for you, man. So if anybody got anything congestion-wise going on, man, y'all get on that honey, lemon, and that ginger tea, man. Yeah. So this morning, we in John chapter 1. We'll be looking at verses 12 through 14. John chapter 1, verses 12 through 14. If y'all don't mind, hit that share button. Let's get the message out to as many people as possible. Shout out to y'all who's still logging on. I see you on here, Sister Lucy, Sister Precious. Thank y'all, Sister Natasha. Thank y'all for being a part of the Morning Motivational Family, y'all. Looking at John chapter 1, verses 12 through 14. Let us pray. God, our Father, as we come to you this morning in the mighty name of your Son, Christ Jesus, Lord, we thank you for you being who you are, God, that you change not. That you are bigger than our situation, bigger than our circumstances, that you are God and you are God alone. And this morning we come to reverence you. We come to give your name praise, honor, and glory. Our request, oh God, is that as we gather in this fashion, that you will bless us with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the things that we read, that you would allow your Holy Spirit to guide us into all truth and revelation. We thank you and we love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Once again, we're looking at John chapter 1, verses 12 through 14. The word reads, "But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, to those who believed in his name, who were born not of blood, nor of flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth." May God add a blessing to the reading, the hearer, but most importantly, the doer of his holy word. So here we have the writer of the book of John, and he's writing, he's kind of giving like a summary. He's kind of giving like an overview. He's talking about Jesus, and he starts off, if you looked on yesterday, he gave us like in the beginning, the word was with God, and the word was God. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. So he's kind of like setting things into play. He's giving you a timeline. He's giving you, the deity of Christ. He's giving you his Godship. He's letting us know that Jesus was forever. He was already here. He was with God in heaven, and he became flesh, and he dwelt among us. So he's giving us, a understanding of God, of Jesus, and how powerful he is, and how he loved us so much that he extended to us the love of God. It says right here in verse 12, it says, but as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become the children of God. So as many as received him, those that accepted him as their Lord and Savior, he gave them the right to become the children of God, to those who believed on his name. It goes further and says, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of man, but of God. Those who were born again. Those who surrendered and said, Lord, create in me, Lord, a new life. Create in me a new heart. God, take this life and you do it as you will. I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. Those that were born again, he gave them an opportunity to be the children of God. And then it goes even further. It says, and the word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. And so right now, as we enter into this season, you know, where the world celebrates Christmas. And that's one thing I really do love about, you know, Christmas, is that you see the whole world. I mean, people who profess not to even believe actually celebrating the birth of the Messiah. People who say they don't even really believe, but they still celebrate. See, people are still in the holiday spirit, in the observance of the Messiah coming to the earth. And so we had an opportunity when he came to the earth, we had an opportunity to hear about what he did, to hear about the miracles that he performed, to see the way he loved, to see the way he cared, the compassion that he had for mankind. And we beheld that. We were able to see that. We were able to put our hands and our arms around that through the writing of the scripture. We hear about it and it's made manifest. And we know that he did that only because the word became flesh. And so this morning, I don't want you to take my word for it, but I need you to get into this word for yourself and look at the word and really meditate on that and understand that if you have not received him, if you have not really truly received him with everything into your heart, into your mind, that this is the time for you to do it. This is the season for you to do it. As, like I said, the world observes the birth of the Messiah. He came into this world, but he came with a purpose. He came knowing that at one point that he would die for you and I. And so we have to make sure that we receive that into our hearts wholeheartedly. But y'all, make sure y'all read y'all word. Sharpen your weapon. Read your word. Jump into the comment box and say, I read my word, y'all. Y'all know how we do. Faith over fear. God over everything. Together we made love great again. Love has never lost its power. It just lost its popularity. And it's been a wrap a long time ago for that foolishness, man. It's time to let that go. Let go and let God. As we wrap up 2021 and as we're moving into 2022, man, don't take that foolishness in there with you, man. Reflect over your life. Be accountable for your actions. Apply God's word to your life, man, and watch miracles manifest on your behalf. When you apply God's words to your life, you're going to see a manifestation of God's power and his love and his grace and his truth when you apply his word to your life and get prepared to live the best of your life the rest of your life, man. I love y'all. God bless you. Y'all know how we do. Y'all come on in real quick. Big hug to y'all. Shout out to y'all who's still logging on, man. I see Justin over here. I see Tina over here. Good morning to you, cuz. I see my cousin over here. I see First Lady jumped on. I see my sister Candace on here, man. Shout out to y'all. I love y'all. I see you on here, Sonya. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. If y'all don't mind, y'all hit that share button. Let's get the message out to as many people as possible. I love y'all. God bless you. Signing off, y'all. It's morning time, family. It is morning time. Catch y'all on the next time. I love y'all. God bless you. And one more hug.